All right, last question on the page. This one will probably take the least amount of time, I would think, anyway. If I look on here, I don't have any distributed property, but look at the symbols, and I've got a lot of subtraction, but I have a multiplication. You always have to make sure with order of operations, excuse me, you do the multiplication division first. So we're going to focus on this first. So I'm going to change this to a fraction because we'll show it the fraction way first. So 3/10 will just be exactly how it says, 3/10. Okay. So I'm going to focus on just multiplying this part together first. So if I do -1/4, it's going to be times a positive, so I know it's going to be negative. Straight across with multiplication, 1 times 3 is just 3. 4 times 10 is going to be 40. And then we're timesing two x's together, so that would be just x to the second power. Now if I look at my other part, I'm not going to be able to put this with this, so I'm not going to worry about finding a common denominator because I'm not going to put this stuff with this anyways. We already have a common denominator here, so let's just focus on that. Now if this is confusing to you with the subtraction and the negatives of the fractions, think about it like this. This is like -half, -half, -half. If I put two negative halves together, I would get a negative whole, or a -1. And then if I take off an extra half, it's just going to be -1.5. So at the beginning of this, if I wanted to, I could just put -1.5. And we can't put those two things together, so that would be the final answer to your question. If you wanted to do this the decimal way, that wouldn't be hard either. Basically, this started as 3/10, so I'll change it back to that. -1/4 is just going to be -0.25x. Then we've got all these halves, and all these halves can just be changed to 0.5s. We've got 0.5, 0.5, 0.5. And they're all negative. Okay? So we're still going to start with the multiplication first. So if I do -0.25 times 3, I'm going to get -0.075. If I look at the rest of it, or the rest of what I have right here, if I do, and it's kind of just like the same concept, and let me put my x to the second power here. It's basically just like the same concept here that we're doing. It's not any different. If I have my 0.5 minus 0.5, our two negative halves are still a whole. Take away another half, it's just going to be -1.5. So those things are exactly the same, because when I do 3 divided by 40, 3 divided by 40 is, you know, just going to come up to be the 0.075 that we had up there. So those are going to be the same things. And then, of course, if we had our negative half down here, because I didn't write, yeah, our -1.5, I'll write this as a decimal. So we'd have -1.5, and then we'd have that. So that would be the same thing as what we had down here. So again, it matches up and it's exactly the same no matter how you do these.